Hello friends, it's me and today TysonBoy34_letscheckout Call of Duty Black Ops 3 Why It Will Suck from TysonBoy34_. Together, let's go. Let's start.
What is going on my YouTubers? Alright, today I'm going to be showing you a little video on why you should not buy Black Ops 3, which is coming out in probably about a year from now. First off, let's go ahead and start with, it is made by Sledgehammer, not by Treyarch or Infinity Ward, which is what we're used to. So a lot of people have been talking about, oh, there's hope for this game, oh, it could be a little better. Well, I'm going to go ahead and tell you, Black Ops is Black Ops, no matter if it's 1, 2, 3, or Quadrillion. They're going to keep on making the same shit games, and I'm going to keep on dying from them and breaking my controller. It's just simply that. Second of all, it doesn't matter what game, who makes this game. All it is going to be campers, like in this kill cam. Target finders, corner camping, that's all the game consists of. The game reached its peak about 5 years ago, and nobody likes it anymore. We play it because it's a familiar franchise, and there's nothing else left to do. Now, Black Ops has been familiar to some very famous overpowered perks, such as Flak Jacket, which I like to call Fag Jacket, as you can see right there, dying by not getting killed by a C4 and a noob tube. And then another very popular one was Ghost. Ghost is not necessarily overpowered as it is helpful, but to be fair, it does need something that can counteract it, like in, what's it called, Call of Duty Ghosts, where you can counteract Dead Silence or whatever the perk is. I forget all the perks' names. There's like 50,000, so there's no point in even trying to remember them. But Ghost was, there was no getting past it. All you had to do was just not be standing still, which campers don't really care about. Second of all, what you're going to always see in a Call of Duty, especially in a Black Ops, is one gun that is completely overpowered and they're not going to give a shit about, and they're not going to nerf it because you paid $60 for it. Why? You can't get your money back, so why do they care? The most famous weapon from Black Ops 2, which was overpowered, which you see me holding now, which I, for some reason, it never works for me. It's like it automatically nerfs when it comes to my hand. I guess it's because I put a silencer on it, but I put a silencer on everything. But anyways, is the AN-94. Now, in this video, you'll see me getting one shot by the AN-94. I forget exactly where it is. This isn't a live commentary because I cannot do live commentary. But as you can see, everyone used the AN-94. I tried to change it up, use the Peacekeeper, because I see, oh, well, 50,000 people in this lobby are using the AN-94. Let's not be a faggot. So I pull out the Peacekeeper, and I try to use it. Another thing in Black Ops 2, which is great, Treyarch has great matchmaking servers, as you can see by the 3 people that are in my lobby versus the 6 people in the other, and it stays for that for a quite large amount of time. So, I mean, Treyarch has terrible servers. You're going to have to deal with that. But I don't know how Sledgehammer is going to run their servers. But, I mean, you're probably going to see the same shit as always. Modern Warfare 3 and Ghost were pretty decent at getting you new servers. I wouldn't say all the time, but usually. But what you'll see is just another game that was hastily peddled out to get a paycheck. And they really won't give a crap about the consumer, which is us, or what he would like. Now, when thinking about a game, if you want a real war-life game, a game that you're going to have fun and that you and your friends are going to enjoy, I'd suggest the Battlefield franchise. It is, I wouldn't say less well-known, but every 12-year-old and his brother plays Call of Duty, and it's just not. You're going to have a bad time if you keep on playing Call of Duty. So you're going to deal with hit markers like these, freaking C4 getting hit markers. It's just going to suck shit the whole time. So I suggest you clearly think about not buying Black Ops 3 and you consider maybe branching out into other franchises. Maybe if you have Xbox, start playing, what's it, Titanfall, or playing freaking Killzone on PS4, which is amazing, or Battlefield 4. But as for Black Ops 3, I think that's going to be the last Call of Duty we'll see that doesn't just suck. Unless they bring Call of Duty Online, which is a very popular game in China, to America. And if you don't know about that game, it's really awesome. I suggest you check it out on Ali A's channel. But anyways, thank you for watching, guys, and you can enjoy the rest of this suckatastrophe. And right here is where I get the one shot by the AN-94, so Go ahead and know that I screamed. I think it's right here. It's coming up. Either way, know that I've broken controller over this current game, so I'm down $60. But anyways, thank you for watching, guys, and it's been my pleasure.
Oh no.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel. And it's hard.
Well, yeah, that's that. I recognize that he's very comfortable with saying a lot of bad words, a lot of vulgarity words, a lot of words that is very insulting. He's very comfortable with that. A lot of bad words. In which, people don't like that. In general, day to day life, people dislike such behaviors. Note that this video came out 10 years ago, back in 2014, so maybe it has changed. Back then, there were, for the gaming community, there is the wholesome gaming community, and there's a toxic gaming community. The sad thing is, the toxic gaming community is significantly louder, significantly unreasonable, and they have more focus, they have more spotlight on them. Right now, it's not as bad as it's because there's regulations, because there's flagging, there is timeouts, there's bans. So things, I hope that things have improved. Anyways, thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed. Subscribe. Thank you. Thank you so much.